You can kill a revolutionary, you cannot kill a revolution. You can kill a man in his move, you cannot kill a movement. You can kill any living thing, but you can never kill a dream. Yet, you still paint him as just a dreamer. When he was a preacher, teacher, leader, firm believer in justice and equality, an organizer, mobilizer, and a changer of policy. Fought for liberation through efforts to end segregation. The same nation that gave him his own day of celebration, the same government that assassinated him, but you still paint him as just a dreamer. When he stood toe-to-toe with Jim Crow, made progress through protests, marched for the right to vote, spoke truth when he was told to stay silent. Water hose stabbed, hit with bricks and knife sticks, and still stood for nonviolence. It wasn't until he died that he became one of the good guys in America's eyes, but you still paint him as just a dreamer, and it's such a shame. These days we praise his name, all hell the king. When alive, he was despised, thrown in jail for nothing. His accomplishments were astonishing. The revolution was televised in Birmingham for the world to see as he marched for justice just to get beaten by police. Motivated millions delivering compelling speeches, exposed racism as one of the nation's deadliest diseases. Yet to you, he's just a dreamer. Which is why all of us have the responsibility to protect this man's legacy as more than just a dreamer, but as a man of action. With a vision that we can hardly fathom, a vision that in 2018 we're working to fulfill. Still, we may not have seen the top of the mountain, but echoes from freedom ringing are forever pounding. So go ahead. Integrate a water fountain, integrate a bus, integrate a lunch counter. Ironic how no shots rang until justice came with economic power. So allow your dream to become a dream deferred, we must refuse. From this demand, not even our divisive president is excused. So many hearts clicked by hate, so King's message remains relevant. Black Lives Matter is the evidence. The Reverend's message remains a testament to everything we've been through, shedding light on all the bad and everything we've endured under the American flag. So excuse us when we take a knee. It's really just our plea that we just want to be free.
All right.
Plantations, free from Jim Crow's deprivations, free from mass incarceration. Ending this evolution, I think it's past time. Revolution begins in the mind. We must battle judge a person not on the color of their skin, but on the content of their character. Not on the color of their skin, but on the content of their character. And truly become the melting pot known as America. Because you can kill a revolutionary, you cannot kill a revolution. You can kill a man in his mind.